sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Telepathy is the mind-to-mind communication of thoughts, ideas, feelings, and mental images. In psychical research, paranormal investigation, and mediumship, telepathy is considered as a potential medium for the transmission of data that appears to be paranormal in origin. Telepathy has been studied in parapsychology in controlled laboratory experiments and in dream research. Telepathy can be both spontaneous and unconscious or deliberate through intention. Various theories have been advanced over the centuries to explain how telepathy works. None is adequate. As Rhine discovered, psychic phenomena bleed into each other, and it is difficult, if not impossible, to separate and quantify different elements of a psychic experience. The ancient Greek philosopher Democritus advanced wave and corpuscle theories. In the 19th century, William Crookes said telepathy rides on radio-like brainwaves. Electromagnetic theories were posited in the 20th century. Carl G. Jung considered telepathy a function of the collective unconscious. More recently, telepathy has been seen as a function of non-local consciousness. It transcends both time and space. Science still has little understanding of exactly how telepathy works. Certain characteristics have been observed, but they do not apply to all cases. It is closely tied to emotional states, both of the sender and receiver. Women are more likely to experience it than men. The telepathic faculty sometimes sharpens with age, perhaps because the physical senses become impaired as age advances. Telepathy can be induced in the dream state. Telepathy has biological connections. Blood volume changes during telepathic sending and recipient's brainwaves change to match those of senders. It is adversely affected by dissociative drugs and positively affected by caffeine. It is more likely to occur during the full moon, suggesting that gravitational or cosmic energy fields play a role in the process. Psychical researchers and paranormal investigators have examined whether or not the effects of mediumship are products of telepathy. For example, a medium might consciously or unconsciously send out mental expectations of results, which are in turn picked up by sitters. One product of this group mind might be spontaneous psychokinesis, PK, effects. Another would be mental impressions of messages and apparitions. Similarly, the thoughts and expectations of people involved in a paranormal investigation might unwittingly influence the results. For example, if one investigator has a strong mental impression of phenomena or witnesses phenomena, a telepathic impression may be transmitted immediately to others who experience the same or similar phenomena. Places known to be haunted might acquire thought-form phenomena, the product of accumulated collective experiences impressed upon the minds of experiencers. The exact nature and role of telepathy in paranormal experience remains uncertain. Advances in science demonstrate the interconnectivity of all things. Thus, the thoughts, feelings, and perceptions of individuals are automatically part of the collective mix in paranormal experience. The experience of paranormal phenomena should not be seen as isolated, objective events, but as part of a holistic experience.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.